It's still so perfect. What's up, guys? Welcome back to Just JP. My name is Justin, and today we'll finally listen to Steve Hackett's solo material with the song Spectral Mornings from his album Spectral Mornings, which was released in May of 1979. So I have a story, so if you want to get to the reaction and the song and everything, you might want to skip ahead a little bit. I'll put a time down here for you, because I'm going to talk for a little bit here. Okay, so as a lot of you already know, if you're on this video, Steve Hackett is on tour, and a lot of you have told me, JP, you need to go see him, blah, 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 look up the dates, we even sent you links. Awesome, thank you guys so much for sending me the link so I could just, like, look and see. So, the closest place that he's playing to me is Orlando. Well, great, that's where I live. Can't get any better than that. There's something particular about March 21st. Allow me to show you. Mm-hmm. You know what this is, guys? That's my wife and I's anniversary. So on the exact same day that Steve Hackett is coming to my town to play, and I would love to see him, it is my wife and I's anniversary. Now, my wife has no interest in listening to Steve Hackett or Genesis. It's not her type of thing, which that's fine. And I told her about this, and I was like, it's not a big deal. It's do I want to see Steve Hackett? Of course. Am I going to, mess up our anniversary for it? No, that's inconsiderate, and that's just not what I do. I need you guys. I need as many of you in the comments to just thank my loving and spectacular wife for saying it's not a big deal. We can celebrate our anniversary the day before, the day of, just in the daytime. We don't have to go out late or anything that day on our anniversary. You can go to your concert. Are you kidding me? Who does that? It took me like 2 months to even buy the tickets because I felt guilty about it. But the whole time, she was like, no, like, really, it's fine. And my wife isn't one of those people that says, no, it's fine, go. But really means, if you buy those tickets, I'm gonna murder you in your sleep. With all her generosity and with all her sincerity, she really did mean that. So if you guys can just in the comments thank her for, in sense, allowing me to go, allowing me to take our anniversary and put it into a different time slot than usual in order to make room for me to go to the concert. So if you're going to the concert that day, I will be there. You are more than welcome to come up to me. I'm probably gonna be shy and quiet, but hey, if you see me there, you're more than welcome to say hi. All right, but let's get into it. You guys can join me on Twitter. You guys can join me in the comments down below, and I hope that you do. I always hope that you do. And let's get into it. This is Steve Hackett with Spectral Mornings. I'm so glad I gave this a listen. I'm so glad I gave this a listen. I feel like I'm gonna have a lot to say on this one. I'm gonna try and contain it though. I'm gonna try and contain it because I already know I have a lot. There's a lot of musicians and bands, very well established in their bands, that go off and make a solo record. Okay? Usually, in my opinion, it's easier for a singer or a vocalist to do that. It's easier for a singer or a vocalist to make a solo album with possibly other musicians from other places or whatever, and make a solo album, because the voice is typically seen as like the central and focal point of a song of music. It's relatively easier to build, in my opinion, something around that. When a guitarist, a bassist, a pianist goes off and makes their solo music, depending on what type it is, of course, I feel like it's a little bit harder because as one of those instruments, I feel like it's harder to remain focused on that, depending on what you're doing. Let's say that you're the pianist or the keyboardist and you go off and make your solo album with a full band. To me, it's hard to not come across as just soloing yourself the whole time when you have a full band backing you. You want them to share parts, even though it's technically your solo band or your solo. And you don't want it to sound boring either. I'm really glad I did this. Steve Hackett took something that, to me, is hard to do. To me, he took guitar, made a solo album out of it, made a song instrumental, focused on the guitar, and it had a lot of repetition in it. But at no point did it sound boring. It was exciting the whole time. I'm glad to have heard this because I've always liked his work in Genesis, obviously. I really like his work in Genesis. But it's interesting to see how a caged bird, which can still sing, when you open up the cage and they come out, they're comfortable, they can stretch their wings a little bit, they sing a little happier, they sing a little more bright, a little more expressive. And that's what I'm feeling with Steve Hackett. He came out of the cage of Genesis, and yes, that was a reference. And from what it seems historically, it looks like he felt a little caged near the ending of his tenure with Genesis, which is why he left. So to see Steve Hackett, who in Genesis is typically a very subdued force in the band, a very strong one, an impressionable one, or an impression-making one, but usually subdued in the band. It's nice to hear what happens when you let him out the cage. It's nice to hear what he can do when he plays the guitar with 100% creative freedom. His guitar playing in this song is so melodically colorful. That I was thinking of the phrase to use the whole time listening to it. There, it is just so bright and exciting, soft yet powerful, subdued yet strong. And one thing I really liked was, and if I'm just focusing on like the guitar playing, is that I think it's the first 3 minutes of this song. The first 3 minutes of this song play out in a pretty repetitive way. Plays guitar, lead, the drums, the hi-hats, woo, the hi-hats. Nice atmospheres in the back. It's a nice crest that it builds up to, and then it comes back down, slows down for like a portion, and then does almost the same melodies building back up into that crest of the wave. And they do that over and over again for like the first 3 minutes of the song. But it sounds good. It's a question I pose all the time. But how do you take something repetitive and continually make it sound good, continually make it sound interesting to listen to for the audience? First, you have to have a really strong melody. He has a really, really strong melody. Listen to it. And the bass in the back. So you got the melody that's really strong. And within each of these contained sections in the beginning, like I said, it builds up, it climaxes, and it comes back down, has a little rest. Then it does the exact same thing. But it's interesting that when you listen to those sections there, each time that it comes back and starts its buildup again, overall, the melody sounds the same, but there's little subtle changes in the back. Whether it's little things in the guitar, drum fills that start to increasingly become a little more noticeable, bass work that comes to the forefront just a little bit more. Sorry, the battery just died, in case you noticed a change or two. There is a subtle but strong buildup as this song continues on and on. It's so perfectly executed. And then that soft, soothing middle before it gets back into its last verse, and yeah, this is such a good song. And can I say that I've never heard Steve Hackett more expressful? Is that the word I'm looking for? We're going with it. We're going with it. Than in this song. I mean, yeah, he's had great solos and great guitar work, obviously, throughout Genesis from what I've heard, but it sounds so reinvigorated here. Right? Doesn't it sound fresh? Well, maybe you guys have listened to so much of his music and Genesis that you already know. But to me, as a newcomer overall to Genesis, this sounds really refreshing to hear. And something else I was thinking, going along with like the expression of his guitar playing, it reminds me a little bit of David Gilmour's playing from Pink Floyd. Specifically, I'm thinking of On an Island, his solo material. He is a great guitar player when it comes to putting feeling into the strings, into the frets of the guitar. I mean, there it is just so beautiful the way that Gilmour plays, especially on that album. And I kind of get the same feeling here, where it's just so soothing, powerful, melodic. It's just everything. And then just looking into the facts of it, it says that this began as a vocal piece when Hackett was writing it. But when he brought it to the band on guitar, Hicks decided that the track sounded great as it is and told Hackett to just keep it as an instrumental piece. This song speaks for itself without vocals. It doesn't need it. It's very fulfilling. Besides the guitar, the bass work is really nice. The atmosphere, I think it's like the keyboards and stuff in the back. I think I've used this analogy before, but the keyboard and the piano and that deep, deep atmosphere layered in this song. Steve Hackett is like a dolphin, and the ocean is the layer of keyboard and piano atmosphere. And Hackett just weaves in and out of there, just weaves in and out. And that hi-hat work on the drumming. Yeah, that's perfect. That's playlist all day. No doubt about that. Does the rest of that album sound like that? Because I might listen to the rest of the album if it sounds like that. Anyways, you guys can join me in the comments down below if you're interested. I hope that you do. You guys can join me on Twitter if you want. I'm around on there. You can email me, you can DM me. I'm reasonably easy to get a hold of. Hope that you guys are having an amazing day, and I will talk to you tomorrow. Bye.